Do you know you can increase traffic to your site, channel, blog by doing proper keyword research? This will help you to rank your channel business organically and grow. In today's video, we are gonna discuss in details about keywords and different types of keywords. Keywords are very important in SEO. Keywords help you understand what people are searching for. They give you direction how you can connect with your audience and viewers and drive organic traffic to your site, channel, blog. So, let's explore different types of keywords we can use while doing SEO. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalam-o-alikuM. This is Sayyida Azra from amfahhtech YouTube channel, where you find all about technology. As I have already told that in this video, we're gonna learn about keywords and different types of keywords. But before we start, if you didn't subscribe my channel yet, so subscribe it right now so that you will be notified whenever I drop a new video. One very important point here is that I also create videos on the request of my viewers and subscribers. So if you want me to create video on any topic, just write me in the comment section. I'll definitely make video for you. Now, let's start our today's video. First of all, let's see what are keywords. Keywords are the words and phrases that people type into search engines to find what they are looking for. For example, if you're looking to buy new shoes, you might type something like buy Gucci shoes into Google. Even though this consists of more than one word, it's still a keyword. Next, let's see different types of keywords, which are short-tail keywords, long-tail keywords, fresh keywords, evergreen keywords, product-defining keywords, customer-defining keywords, geo-targeting keywords, LSI keywords, and intent-targeting keywords. Now, let's discuss all these keywords one by one. Number one is short-tail keywords. As the name suggested, short-tail keywords are the short keywords that are made up of two or less words. These are also called as head keywords. For example, digital marketing, or you can say SEO, are short tail keywords. Short tail keywords are more general search queries. For example, if you're looking for digital marketing, we can search here digital marketing, and this yields many millions of results because this is a very general query and there's no specific information that we require for digital marketing. We just need general information. So that's why we are typing here digital marketing. Let's see here some characteristics of the short tail keywords. Short tail keywords have the high search volume because this yields many millions of results, and the high CR, which means high competitive rate, broad search intent, and low conversion rate, because the user or the searcher just need the broader information about digital marketing. They don't know any specific information. So the shorter keywords have the low conversion rate. Next is long tail keyword. Long tail keywords consist of more than three words. These are usually much more specific than short tail keywords. For example, when we're looking for such general information about digital marketing, then we can use short tail keywords like digital marketing. But if we want to know digital marketing agency in Pakistan, we use this keyword, and this keyword is much more specific to what we're looking for. And I also recommend to use long tail keywords, as it's easier to rank high with long tail keywords, and users when visited your site, channel, are much more likely interested in your channel and will stay there for long. See here some characteristics. Long tail keywords have low search volume, low competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate, and the users uses this keyword for targeted pages. Next is fresh keywords. When you think about fresh keywords, you need to think about something that is hyped recently. Like these keywords are related to latest trends. You can add these fresh keywords to your content to drive in immediate traffic. This represents the current interest and searches of the users. For example, this keyword T20 Cricket World Cup is the trending keyword in these days because this is a season of T20 Cricket World Cup. So this is a keyword that is trending nowadays. So we call this keyword as a fresh keyword. The characteristics of fresh keywords will be explosive search volume, medium competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Evergreen keywords. Evergreen keywords are those keywords that are relevant all the time. The search volume might fluctuate now and then, but there won't be extreme changes. For example, the keyword how to earn money online, this is an evergreen keyword because this phrase always be searched on internet and its search volume will always remain moderate, which means that these keywords maintain their search volume. So now the characteristics of these evergreen keywords are moderate search volume, medium competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Next is product defining keywords. These are the keywords that explain and describe your product. For example, the keyword online shoes showing our shorted keyword, and if we remove online and type Gucci shoes, this become product defining keyword. We use these keywords when we are more specific about our need. The characteristics of product defining keywords are low search volume, low competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Next is customer defining keywords. These are the personal targeted keywords, like creating an imaginary profile for your targeted audience. For example, Gucci shoes for men, directly related to the customer that users is interested in Gucci shoes for men. Such keywords are customer defining, so this is a customer defining keywords. Another example of customer defined keywords is kids bike, because the searcher wants to know information about bike that is related to the kids. The characteristics of customer defined keywords are low search volume, low competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Now we have geo-targeting keyword. These keywords are like specific neighborhood, city, state, or even country. For example, the keyword coffee shop in Lahore. These type of keywords where we mention area and location are geo-targeting keywords. These keywords are useful for small local businesses and delivery-based business. The characteristics of the geo-targeting keywords is low search volume, low competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Next are LSI keywords, latent semantic indexing. These keywords are thematic keywords that are closely related to your main keywords. For example, if we type coffee here, coffee is our main keyword, and here down, you find many other keywords like coffee brands, coffee near me, coffee shop, coffee benefits, coffee powder, coffee types, coffee beans, coffee brand. These are basically so many theme-based keywords which are related to our main keyword, coffee. And these theme-based keywords are called as LSI keywords. In order to find LSI keywords, you first need to decide your main keyword. Let's see here some characteristics. LSI keywords have low search volume, low competitive rate, specific search intent, and high conversion rate. Here, the last one is intent targeting keyword. When a user performs a query, the intent would fall into four categories: informational keywords, navigational keywords, commercial keywords, and transactional keywords. Let's find out what these are. Informational keywords. These are the keywords where searchers looking for an answer to specific question or general information. For example, what is SEO and how to make coffee? These are the examples of general information where the user wants to know information about SEO. And an example of informational keyword is best shoes. By looking at this keyword, it seems like user wants to know about best shoes, wants to get information about best shoes, doesn't want to buy or anything else. We can also see blogs here as a result of this keyword. Next, navigational keywords. Navigational keywords. In this case, searchers intending to find a specific site or page, for example, YouTube, Facebook, is a navigational keyword because the intent is to access Facebook page. An example of navigational keyword is YouTube. Here also the user wants to go to the YouTube site. Navigational keyword is also an alternative to find the URL of the site. Next, commercial keywords. These are the keywords where the searcher is looking to investigate brand or services. For example, best coffee brands. For example, buy best shoes. And if we use and type this keyword, the user will get e-commerce link of many sites so that he can buy, because in this case, the user has the intent to buy shoes by looking at this keyword. The last one is transactional keywords. These are the keywords where searchers intending to complete an action, which means wants to purchase. There's no big difference between commercial intent and transactional intent. For example, now like user have made up his mind to purchase Adidas shoes, Gucci shoes, and wants to see if there's any sales or offers on this Adidas shoes. So just before to purchase Adidas shoes, the user wants to see offers and sales on these shoes. So he types Adidas shoes sales and offers. So this is the intent, which shows user has selected shoes and now wants to purchase it. And he has selected Adidas shoes, and before purchase, he wants to see some sales on these shoes. So this is intent, which is called transactional intent. And an example of transactional intent is coffee shops near me that deliver. These keywords also shows intent of the users to purchase or buy. So this is all done for. In today's tutorial, we have learned keywords and different types of keywords, which are very important in SEO to rank and grow your channel, site and blog, etc. I hope you find this video very helpful. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever I drop a new video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.